Have you ever wondered what it takes to build a solar farm in Poland? Asks Marco Hernaiz, Lighthief's CEO. Today, we break down this process into simple, understandable steps. Imagine harnessing the power of the sun to generate clean, renewable energy, not just for a home, but for an entire community. Exciting, isn't it? But the process of building a solar farm is more than just planting solar panels in a field. It's a complex process that requires careful planning, negotiation, and cooperation with various stakeholders, including energy network operators, local authorities, and construction professionals. Understanding this process is crucial to avoid any potential delays and ensure the timely completion of the project, adds Mr. Hernaiz, CEO of Lighthief. From the initial negotiations to the final inspections, every step is orchestrated to bring this sustainable power source to life. So buckle up as we embark on this enlightening journey. From the plains of Poland to the far corners of the world, let's explore how solar farms are built, step by step. Firstly, negotiating and signing an agreement with the energy network operator is a crucial step. This agreement sets the stage for the connection of your solar farm to the grid, a step that cannot be bypassed or taken lightly. It's the foundation upon which the rest of your project rests, the cornerstone of your solar farm's future success. But that's not all. The acquisition of design documentation and the assignment of rights is another key aspect of this process. A tripartite agreement needs to be concluded between the operator, the previous owner, and you, the new buyer. This agreement paves the way for the continuation of the investment and ensures that all the involved parties are on the same page. Now, let's talk about connection conditions. As time marches on, so does technology. The latest and greatest PV panels and inverters of today may be outdated tomorrow. So it's crucial to keep your connection conditions updated to reflect any changes in these components. This might seem like a small detail, but remember, in a project of this magnitude, every detail counts. The beginning formalities don't end here. The transformer station is another significant element you need to pay attention to. It's the beating heart of your solar farm, the hub that ensures the smooth operation of your investment. You need to agree on the details regarding its construction and operation with the network operator, and this needs to be a priority to avoid any delays or hiccups due to delivery or lack of documentation. So there you have it. The beginning formalities might seem tedious, and yes, they require your time, attention, and patience. But they're the building blocks of your solar farm, the steps that set everything else in motion. And remember, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. This step is vital due to the long process from submitting an application for connection conditions to the actual start of construction. The transformer station is a key element of the PV farm. Why, you ask? Well, it's the nerve center of the whole operation, converting the energy from solar to electrical and enabling it to be fed into the grid. Without it, all those gleaming solar panels would be, well, just good-looking pieces of hardware. Now, building a transformer station is not something you can just wing. It involves a lot of intricate planning and coordination with the energy network operator. You see, the operator has to ensure that the station fits into the larger grid network seamlessly. So discussions about the construction and operation of the transformer station must take place. This includes, but is not limited to, the station's design, its capacity, and its operational procedures. But why is planning the transformer station a priority? It's simple. A well-planned transformer station reduces the chances of hiccups down the line. It ensures that all components are delivered on time and that the necessary documentation is in place. This way, there's no unnecessary downtime during construction, and the project stays on track. Consider this. The transformer station is like the heart of the solar farm. It must be in tip-top shape for the rest of the body, the panels, the inverters, the cabling, to function effectively. And just like a heart, it must be carefully planned and built. This means cooperating with the network operator, getting the right components on time, and ensuring that all the necessary documents are in order. So, in essence, transformer station planning is all about foresight. It's about anticipating potential issues and mitigating them before they become real problems. It's about ensuring that everything runs like clockwork, From the moment the first foundation is laid to the moment the first watt of electricity is fed into the grid. Remember, delays due to delivery or lack of documentation can be avoided with proper planning. So, let's get it right from the start. That way, our solar farm will be more than just a gleaming field of panels. It'll be a well-oiled machine producing clean, renewable energy, day in, day out. Now that arrangements are in place, it's time to order the necessary components. The heart and soul of a solar farm revolve around some essential elements. Photovoltaic or PV panels, for instance, are the workhorses, converting sunlight into electricity. Then we have inverters, transforming the direct current from the panels into alternating current that can be used in homes and businesses. But the list doesn't end here. We also need to procure fencing for the site. Not only does this provide security, but it also demarcates the boundaries of our solar farm. And let's not forget cabling, a vital component that connects all the parts together, ensuring the smooth transmission of power. Once we've placed orders for these components, it's time to get our hands dirty with some tests. And these are not your run-of-the-mill exams. We're talking about pull-out tests and geological tests. These tests are crucial in determining the depth of our solar farm's foundation. Pull-out tests are conducted to determine the load-bearing capacity of our soil. They involve installing a test pile and applying a load to see how the soil reacts. This helps us understand how well our structure will be supported. On the other hand, geological tests give us a detailed understanding of the ground beneath us. They reveal vital information such as the type of soil, its composition, and any potential challenges we might face during construction. These tests might seem like a lot of work, but they are absolutely essential. They provide a clear picture of what lies beneath the surface, enabling us to design a foundation that will stand the test of time. They provide the assurance that our solar farm will remain sturdy and functional for years to come, generating clean, renewable energy. In the world of solar farm construction, the devil is in the detail. Every component, every test counts. And understanding this is key to building a project that not only stands up, but stands out. These tests will determine the depth of the foundation of the structure, a critical detail in construction. With all necessary documents in hand, the next step is preparing a construction design and applying for a building permit. Now, for those of you who may not be familiar with the term, a construction design is essentially a detailed plan of how the solar farm will be built. It includes everything from the layout of the solar panels to the wiring and cabling system. Once your construction design is ready, it's time to apply for a building permit. This is a critical step in the process because without a building permit, construction cannot legally begin. It's important to note that the process of obtaining a building permit can be time-consuming, so it's best to start this process as early as possible. In addition to the building permit, one must also register a construction log. The construction log is a record of all the activities that take place during the construction phase. It's a crucial document for tracking progress, resolving disputes, and maintaining transparency between all parties involved in the project. But before the first shovel hits the ground, there's one more important step: informing the construction supervision inspector about the commencement of work. The inspector's role is to ensure that all construction activities are carried out according to the approved design and in compliance with safety regulations. Now let's talk about insurance. Building a solar farm is a substantial investment, and like any investment, it comes with risks. These risks can range from delays in construction to damage to equipment. That's why it's absolutely essential to take out an insurance policy that covers these risks. The right insurance policy can protect your investment and provide peace of mind. And here's a little heads up for you. Some insurers require the submission of an application up to 3 months before the commencement of work, so don't wait until the last minute to get your insurance in place. Start the process early and ensure that you're fully covered when construction begins. And remember, some insurers require the submission of an application up to 3 months before the commencement of work. With formalities out of the way, it's time to start the actual construction of the solar farm. One of the key players in this stage is the construction manager. This individual, ideally experienced and knowledgeable in the renewable energy industry, is tasked with numerous responsibilities. They oversee the construction process, ensuring that everything runs smoothly and according to plan. They're also responsible for occupational health and safety training and the preparation of related documentation, ensuring that everyone on site is well-versed in safety protocols. Let's delve into the construction process itself. The first step is for the surveyor to determine the fence line and the exact location of the supporting structure. This is a crucial step, as it lays out the physical boundaries of the solar farm and ensures that all components will be placed in their optimal positions. After the boundaries are set, the construction team can start erecting the fences and building the support structures. These structures will hold the photovoltaic panels, or PV panels, which convert sunlight into electricity. It's a meticulous process, as each panel must be installed at the correct angle to maximize sunlight exposure. Next, the inverters are installed. These devices convert the direct current generated by the PV panels into an alternating current, which can be fed into the electrical grid. The cabling is also set up during this stage, connecting the various components of the solar farm together and to the grid. In the midst of all this, it's crucial to remember that everything must be conducted in accordance with the design documentation. Every detail, from the positioning of the panels to the layout of the cabling, must follow the design to ensure optimal performance and safety. It's also important that all safety standards are strictly adhered to, protecting the workers on site and ensuring the longevity of the solar farm. Construction must be conducted in accordance with design documentation and appropriate safety standards. It's a mantra that must be repeated and followed throughout this stage of the process, laying the foundation for a successful and productive solar farm. After construction is completed, it's time for inspections, licensing, and setting up maintenance routines. One of the first post-construction steps involves technical and measurement inspections. These checks are crucial to ensure that the solar farm is built to specifications and is ready for operation. These inspections might include thermal imaging tests and zero cleaning, which are used to verify the integrity of the structure and the functionality of the PV panels. Once the inspections are completed and all the necessary adjustments are made, it's time to move on to securing an energy production license. This is an official document issued by the Energy Regulatory Office, granting the solar farm the right to produce and supply energy. It's not uncommon for this process to involve a bit of negotiation, but it's a critical step in getting your solar farm up and running. Next, you'll need to conclude a distribution agreement with the network operator. This agreement outlines the terms and conditions for feeding the solar farm's energy into the grid. It's a vital part of the process, as it ensures the energy produced by your solar farm reaches consumers. But it's not enough to just build and start running your solar farm. To ensure it keeps operating at optimal levels, you'll need a solid maintenance routine in place. This includes regular monitoring of the SCADA system, which helps you keep track of various aspects of the solar farm's performance. It's also advisable to perform regular maintenance checks on all equipment, especially the PV panels and inverters, to prevent any potential issues from escalating into major problems. Remember, building a solar farm is not just about the construction. It's a journey that involves meticulous planning, rigorous inspections, acquiring necessary licenses, and ensuring regular maintenance. Each step is crucial in its own right, and missing even one could lead to delays or worse, a non-functioning solar farm. And with that, your solar farm is built and ready to become a stable source of income. Building a solar farm is a complex but manageable task. It's a journey that begins with formalities, such as negotiating and signing agreements with energy network operators and previous owners to enable the continuation of the investment. Connection conditions are updated to accommodate changes in components like PV panels and inverters, keeping in mind the long duration from application to construction start. The transformer station, an essential part of the PV farm, requires detailed planning and agreement with the network operator. This step is a priority to avoid delays due to delivery or lack of documentation. Once these arrangements are in place, the procurement of necessary components like PV panels, inverters, fencing, and cabling begins. The journey continues with pullout tests and geological tests, determining the depth of foundation for the structure. After obtaining all necessary documents, construction design preparation and application for a building permit follows. Registration of a construction log and notification of commencement of work to the construction supervision inspector are also part of the process. Connection and cable route design are crucial if the connection point is remote from the construction plot. It involves obtaining transmission easements, preparing a cable route design, and submitting it to the district office. An experienced construction manager with knowledge of the renewable energy industry is indispensable, responsible for occupational health and safety training and documentation related to occupational safety. Before work begins, an insurance policy that covers risks associated with the construction of a solar farm is necessary. Once the formalities are completed, the actual construction of the farm begins. Post-construction, technical and measurement inspections are carried out, including thermal imaging tests and zero cleaning, reporting the readiness of the farm for energy generation, concluding a distribution agreement with the network operator, applying for an energy production license, and negotiating an agreement for the sale of energy from the farm are the final steps, says Marco Hernaiz, Lighthief's founder. Remember, every step of the process is crucial to building a successful and efficient solar farm. Until next time, keep shining.